Hey, what's up, guys? I always hated wind, but I was always interested in renewable energy, so I figured if I manage to build a wind turbine and reduce my electricity bill, I will for sure start to like windy days. So my goal here is to build a wind turbine which is capable of producing 1.5 kilowatts of energy. It actually might produce more, but let's go with 1.5 kilowatt, which would be very good already. This is not going to be an how-to video, as I'm learning myself how to build one of these as I go. So just keep an eye on my channel and I will keep you updated on the progress. If everything goes fine, I will build some kind of controller that monitors the current wind speed, RPM of the wind turbine, current power being produced, volts and amps, and all this information will be uploaded to some kind of IoT service so I can get detailed graphs. I will also implement a brake system that shorts the outputs of the wind turbine in case the RPMs get too high. But enough of talking, let's start. Okay, so just a very fast and basic explanation on how the wind turbine will work. It will consist of a stator with 9 coils, each with 70 turns or 14 gauge or 1.6 mm enameled copper wire, and this stator will be sandwiched in between two steel discs containing 12 neodymium magnets each. As the discs turn, AC electricity will be produced, which then needs to be rectified to get usable DC current, which can be used for example to charge batteries or can be injected to the grid using a grid tie inverter. Today I'm starting with the discs. Okay, so the discs I'm using are 40 cm in diameter, so about 12 inches, and are 6 mm thick or about a quarter inch. A lot of people use brake discs for this, which is fine if you can get them free, but I got mine laser cut with the right dimensions for 6 euros each, or about $6.70. And for such a low price, I don't think it is worth to use brake discs. I used sandpaper to get rid of rust and to roughen the surface, so the magnets stick better, then I used paint thinner to clean it. Please don't mind the shaky video, this was recorded using a security camera and it was a little windy. I bet that as soon as I finish the wind turbine and I'm ready to test it, the wind will completely vanish for at least a week. That's how lucky I am. I designed and 3D printed these templates for the magnets, but I could have done this manually with wood. To glue the magnets, I'm using a drop of super glue. This is just temporary, since later in this video I will pour polyester resin on top of the magnets and the disc. As you know, the magnets have two polarities, and the way you have to glue them to the disc is, if the last magnet has the north side facing up, you have to glue the next magnet with the south side facing up, or vice versa. As you can see, I'm testing here. So the face that repels to the last magnet is the one that is going to stick to the disc. And in the end, you should always test if all the magnets are correctly in the correct position, as you can always knock them off. As you can see, I'm using a trowel to get it off, because it wasn't quite in the right position. I recommend using gloves to do this, because you know these are quite strong, and if you get a finger between two of these, it's quite painful, trust me. These magnets are N52 grade and are 1 inch by 2 inch by half inch, or 50 by 25 by 10 millimeters. So to contain the polyester resin, I'm using this foil tape. Since it's quite wide, I'm cutting it in half, so I can use it for both discs. Same thing inside. You can use any other type of tape, as long as it glues quite good to the disc and it doesn't leak. Make sure you are working on a leveled surface. I'm just using normal polyester resin, which is also known as fiberglass resin. And you can get this in any home improvement store. I used about 200 milliliters for the two discs. Oh, I don't recommend using a can to do this, because it gets attracted to the magnets. I didn't think about that. So you can use like a the bottom of a bottle, for instance. You want to fill the spaces between the magnets, but not up to the surface of the magnets. We want the magnets to stick out a little bit, but still you want to cover the magnets with a thin layer. Unfortunately, I don't have a picture of the finished discs, but I will show you in the next video. And that's it for today. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and thumbs up, and please comment. I never received a comment on this channel, which I don't know if something's not right with my YouTube channel, or people just don't comment. So go ahead and leave a comment. Have fun.